A discrimination tree is a knowledge structure in which the cases themselves are at the leaf nodes of the tree. At the root node and at all the intermediate nodes are questions. The questions at the root node and the intermediate node pertain to the indexical structures of the cases. So recall that we were using the origins of the cases as the indexical structure. Let's stay with that point for just a while longer. So now I might have a question at the root node which says, is the origin north of 5 of n? If the answer to that question is yes, then it brings us to this branch. If the answer is no, it takes us to the other branch. At this node, I might ask, is the origin east of 5 of e? If yes, it brings us to this branch. If no, it brings us to that branch. And this way, we have been able to discriminate between C and A. In fact, we have been able to discriminate between C and all of the cases. Similarly, for this part of the branch. So now that we have learned what is the knowledge structure of discrimination trees for organizing the case memory, let us now look at how will we store a new case? How will we incrementally learn this knowledge structure as new cases are put into the case memory? Imagine that there is a new case, X. So we can navigate this tree using X. Is the origin of X north of 5 of n? Yes, it is. So we come to this branch. Is the origin of X east of 5 of e? No, it is not. So we come to this branch. But now we have a problem. Both A and X have the same answer, no, to this question. We must find a way of discriminating between A and X. So we'll add a new question here. Perhaps we can add a new question. Is the origin east of 3 of E? In case of X, the answer is yes. In case of A, the answer is no. Thus, by adding the right node at the right place, we have found a way of discriminating between X and A. This now is a modified discrimination tree. Each time we add a new case into memory, the organization of the case in the memory changes. This is an example of incremental learning. With the addition of each case, some new knowledge structure is learned. We'll learn more about incremental learning in the next lesson.
So going back to our programming example, we were dealing with cases of file input, and we could use the same indexical structure according to which we organized our cases to now design a discrimination tree. At the very top level, I would probably ask, what language is the case in? Is it in Java, C++, Python? Now, the discrimination trees don't have to be binary like they are right here. We could have more than two answers coming out. So at the top level, I could have a question of what language is the case in, and the branches could be Java, C++, and Python, and so on. I could similarly have questions about, is it an efficient solution? Is it for a big problem or a small problem? Is it for my personal use or is it for consumer use? And so on until I get down to individual cases that represent different things I might want to consider when I'm doing a new solution.
David, the point you make about this not being a binary tree is a very important one. Let's go back to our original example where we had a micro world of blocks and the blocks had different colors. So I can ask the question at the root node, what is the color of the block? And I have a large number of branches coming out of it corresponding to different colors. That's an example where the discrimination tree is not a binary tree.